Tomorrow's by-election in the federal seat of Eden-Monaro in southern New South Wales is expected to be a photo finish. There are 14 candidates in all, but all eyes will be on these three. There is plenty of pressure on Christy McBain to retain the seat for Labor, but it is now up for grabs.
Tomorrow's by-election for the seat of Eden-Monaro is sure to be close. Labor won the seat by 0.9% at the last federal election, with only 800 votes separating the major parties. The retiring member Mike Kelly was a popular figure, and there are concerns for Anthony Albanese that Labor won't retain the seat without him.
We've lost a popular sitting member in Mike Kelly, so we started not on 51 but on 48.
The Liberals are running the same candidate they did at the general election, but only after a messy rundown, with Andrew Constance announcing his candidacy before pulling out. The Nationals' John Barilaro also expressed an interest before pulling out as well.
I chose not to run in this election. I had every opportunity to run in this election. I've ruled it out. I've got to focus on the state. I'm the Deputy Premier and we'll see how we go.
The electorate is a vast one, almost touching the Victorian border, running up the south coast of New South Wales and taking in the Labor heartland of Queanbeyan and even touching the state seat of Wagga Wagga. Eden-Monaro has been a traditional bellwether electorate. That is, one which usually goes with the government of the day. But that's until recently. Scott Morrison will be hoping to turn around the Liberals' fortunes in the seat in recent times and pick it up to expand his majority in the House of Representatives.
And on Saturday, I hope she can form part of my government, because I think that will be what's best for Eden-Monaro.
I think there's a message that needs to be sent to the government this Saturday, which is they're keeping a whole lot of these cuts secret until after the by-election.
No opposition has lost a seat that it holds at a by-election in more than 100 years. But history isn't necessarily running against the government. The last time it happened was in the middle of, wait for it, a global pandemic. Anyone that tells you they know the way that this seat's going to go is lying. It is far too close to call. Both sides will be hopeful for the momentum that a win builds ahead of the August return of Parliament.